Andrew Bogish comes in. He's got two young children. He's nodding his head. You have dealt with hand, foot, and mouth disease.
Well, knock on wood, D.A., or whatever this beautiful desk is made of, we have yet to actually bring it into the Bogish household. Oh. But friends all around us have had it. I mean, you go to a bouncy castle, any kind of birthday party factory where there's kids everywhere, the playground, the pool. I mean, this is not in any way surprising. Now, it's surprising it's in an adult, but this is, we call it Coxsackie. That's the virus behind it.
Uh-huh.
It's not fun.
Isn't that
at all.
A town in upstate New York?
It is also that I believe there's an extra, the one upstate has less letters in it. But yeah, it's not at all fun. I mean, for a little kid, it's terrible because you get blisters in your mouth, in your throat, on your hands. I mean, it's a high fever. It's bad, bad news.
Now, apparently, he was at a children's camp.
Yeah, I mean, I knew that had to be the explanation. Either he had like a nephew that was somewhere. That's how you get it, in like little germ infestation places.
So what we're saying is a young child may have not washed up after going to the bathroom and then shakes Noah's hand, or Noah picks him up or something and his hand gets towards Noah's mouth.
I can't guarantee
that
the potty was involved, but I mean it spreads like wildfire.
It's not just from...
No, I mean it could be anything. They could have just had it, they could be getting it, their brother had it and it's on them and you touch, you pick up. I mean you could have picked up, like somebody could have thrown him a baseball with it on it. It spreads so fast.
Okay.
And so easily.
But okay, so what you're saying is a kid picks up a baseball, 7-year-old, throws it to Noah Syndergaard, he catches it. Noah Syndergaard contracts hand, foot, and mouth disease. That kid that picked up the baseball didn't necessarily put a virus from potty on there.
No.
It could be anything.
He could have sneezed and grabbed the ball. I mean, kids are dirty. And then Noah just wipes his nose or, you know, goes, oh, I got a piece of luncheon on my finger. And then off we go. Now, to be on the serious front, I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if, like, the Mets can't play games at some point this week because they've got, like, 19 guys scratching with fevers and stuff like that. I mean, that's definitely on the table.
They sent him home.
He
can't be around any of the team.
They probably won't tell us because they're the Mets, but, I mean, they could have, like, burned things, washing things in bleach. Like, once that stuff gets in your little stratosphere, it doesn't leave.
Is it possible Jody Mack has sneezed hand, foot, and mouth disease around here?
I think Jody Mack is patient zero. He's the originator with him.
Do we have John Ricco talking about this? This is so good. He has no idea what he's talking about here.
Noah Syndergaard is going to be placed on the DL. He contracted, let me get this right, hand, foot, and mouth disease. You never know where he picks this up, but we think he worked at a youth camp over the All-Star break.
Yeah. And he was licking flagpoles during the All-Star break.
It's not a long-term thing. Where hopefully just misses the one start.
I mean, literally, this season has gone from figuratively eating feces for the Mets to literally...
I mean, only the Mets. And then Ike Davis had, like, Rocky Mountain Valley fever. Like,
Valley fever.
Who gets these things? Why... It's only the Mets. It's only the Mets.
Let me get this right.
Let me get this right.
Hand, foot, and mouth disease.
Let me get this right. It's called the poopy disease.
Yeah, basically. We've tried to talk to him about it, and it finally backfired.
Oh, God. It's so gross.
Yeah.